my channel if you are new. My name is Eva and I'm doing lifestyle and motherhood videos. And today I am coming with my Canadian citizenship story. I will tell you how I did get to Canada and the whole process. Up to yesterday, I finally had my ceremony and it was such a cute moment, but I will get to that. So if you are interested, if you perhaps are in that process of becoming a Canadian citizenship, to become a Canadian, and you know, you are interested of the test and in general you just want to listen to other people's story, then this video is definitely for you. So let's jump right in. So first of all, I will tell you a little bit of like the back story, how did I get to Canada and all of that. So in 2012 I met my Canadian husband, his husband now, at that time he was just a stranger than a boyfriend. Anyway, he came to Poland. He is Polish Canadian, first generation. His parents are immigrants, so he went to Poland for 2012 Euro Cup. Poland and Ukraine were hosting. So he came because why not, perfect time. And it happened that I was working with his cousin. So she introduced us and, you know, long story short, a week later, like legit a week later, I decided that I am going to move to Canada. So I quit my job, I just graduated from my bachelor. So, you know, it was like now or never. And yeah, in 2012, I think in August I came, yes, 2012. In 2013 I got married, and instead of applying for my PR card, we moved to Bermuda for 1 year. So in 2014 I applied for my PR. And if you are new to Canada, or maybe you don't know, up to this point I was on a tourist visa, so I could not work. I didn't have a health card, so I would have to pay for everything. And in 2014 we finally applied. I had to wait 2 years. 2 years, guys, for receiving my PR, but I finally did. I think in August 2016 I got my PR. So I was on that PR for a little bit, and then, you know, a few years later you finally think that it's time to get citizenship. So for that there are a few requirements. I don't remember how many years you have to be in Canada, but that PR time is included. So I think around 5. And I think I did get it, or maybe you don't even need PR, I don't know. You have to check it out, because I'm not sure, I don't remember. But another thing is that you need to have your language, English or French. If you don't know, Canada is bilingual, so English or French on like a specific level. But to be honest, that's not very high at all. So yeah, I slowly, you know, I didn't want to do it, because you need like a proper certificate that you know language at a specific level. And in my case, I had to go to school for like 100 hours just to get a certificate. I think the minimum level is 4, and I was on like I think 9. So much more, my English was much better than the minimum. Anyway, I decided to go, okay? I think I applied beginning of 2019, March 2019. That's where I applied for my citizenship. So the waiting time for your citizenship is about 1 year. And so not very long. So you would think, how the heck, it's 2021 and you are planning 2020. So well, I got the invitation for the test like the historical test in 2020, January 2020, I got email that my test is going to be in the next few days, because back then you only got like few days, no more than that. And it happened that I was in Mexico, so I had to reschedule, and we all know what happened after that, right? The whole world went into lockdown, so that's what happened. We went into lockdown, everything was closed, and I had to wait another year to get the invitation. You know, for the longest time everything was closed. They didn't know how long they're going to be in lockdown, and they definitely decided to do it online on the computer in your home, and before you would have to go in person for the test. So I have to say that this is so much easier for me, and I also got more time to prepare. I got invitation for the test, I think I had like almost a month, or like up to 2 weeks, like definitely long time enough to study. So when it's coming to study, the only thing I was studying is that Discover Canada book. You can go and download it on a Canadian website, Canadian immigration website. They can send you a paper copy if you would like. I think I was only using the online version. I did lots of, you know, online tests, the one day offer you for free. If you want, you can spend $30 and buy like tons and tons of questions after each chapter of the book. But to be honest, like, the test, it's really, really easy. Sometimes people say that it was tricky. Like, there is nothing tricky. Maybe it was tricky for you. It's your language barrier. That's why you're saying it was tricky, because for me, there was nothing tricky at all. So I think I got like 19 of 20 questions. I don't know what question I got wrong. I think that was the one I didn't pay too much attention in the book. So, and also there was no dates. So that's great, because I know some people suck dates. I kind of memorize them, because, you know, I'm just gonna learn Canadian history once and then probably forget it. So I wanted to do my best. So I learned the dates. You don't have to, like, really. I don't think so there's like anything with dates. So after that, I received email asking me to send them copy of my passport once again, and that's what I did. And I didn't hear anything for a while, and then eventually I checked the website. Keep checking the website, because there is, you know, you can get update there, but you won't get the email. So it's very important that you go there and you check. And good luck, glad I did, because I got invitation for my citizenship ceremony, saying over there that I did receive email when I did not. So in this case, I am on a group with the citizenship people. If something says that you should have it and you don't, then you have to contact your office immediately. I would say go by email, not by phone, because they have so much work and it's not their responsibility to make sure that you have all the information you have to know, okay? It's your future, it's your business. So if the website says you should receive something and you did not, you have to contact them. You do not wait until your ceremony date, because it's gonna be too late by then. So that being said, yesterday I finally had my ceremony. Now I am waiting for my certificate, and from there I can apply for my passport. And I think my journey to Canadian citizenship is finally over after so many years. I have my place in the world, and I just couldn't be happier. So that's it for today. Very short update. I hope it did help you. If it did, give me a big thumbs up, comment your story down below, and I hope I will see you with my next video. Bye, guys.